Get your Bible and your manual. Bow down your heads, let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for another beautiful Sunday. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Teach us your word and help us to understand. In Jesus' almighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good. So children, the topic for today is water from the rock. Water from the rock. Yes. The topic again is water from the rock. And the text is Numbers 21 to 11. The text is taken from Numbers 21 to 11. Numbers 21 to 11. And our topic is water from the rock. A lot of you will wonder, water from the rock. Have you ever seen a rock before or a stone? Can water come out from it? We will know. Water from the rock is the topic for today. So let's look at our text, Numbers 21 to 11. The Israelites, the whole congregation, came into the wilderness of Zin in the first month, and the people stayed in Kadesh. Miriam died there and was buried there. Now there was no water for the congregation, so they gathered together against Moses and against Aaron. The people quarreled with Moses and said, "Would that we had died when our kindred died before the Lord. Why have you brought the assembly of the Lord into this wilderness for us and our livestock to die here? Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to bring us to this wretched place? It is no place for grain or figs or vines or pomegranates, and there is no water to drink." Then Moses and Aaron went away from the assembly to the entrance of the tent of meeting. They fell on their faces, and the glory of the Lord appeared to them. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Take the staff and assemble the congregation, you and your brother Aaron, and command the rock before their eyes to yield its water. Thus you shall bring water out of the rock for them. Thus you shall provide drink for the congregation and their livestock." So Moses took the staff from before the Lord, as he had commanded him. Moses and Aaron gathered the assembly together before the rock. And he said to them, "Listen, you rebels, shall we bring water for you out of this rock?" Then Moses lifted up his hand and struck the rock twice with his staff. Water came out abundantly, and the congregation and their livestock drank. The congregation were complaining, "Why did he bring them where there is no water to a wretched place?" They were angry, they were complaining, they shouted at Moses and Aaron. What did they do? Did Moses and Aaron shout back at them? No! They went and they fell down to their faces, and God showed up to them. They went to meet with God. They didn't shout back. They did not complain. They didn't fight with them. And God told them what to do after they prayed to God. And they did exactly what God told them to do. And water came in abundance. So much water that they all drank, and their livestock drank as well. That takes us to our lesson for today. Lesson number one is that you should trust God. Trust in God, because he is able to do all things. God is all-knowing and he is powerful. He is to do all things. So you should always trust in God. Don't complain or feel bad when people say bad things about you. You complain, you grumble, you go and cry. No, you should trust God. And when you trust God, lesson number one, trust God. And when you trust God, it takes us to lesson number two. You will always go to God in prayers. You will always go to Him for help. It is only when you trust somebody that you can go to that person for help, because you know that person is able. So one, you have to trust because God is able. Lesson number two is that you go to Him for help in prayers. The Bible says this is the confidence we have in Him, that when we pray, He would hear us and He will answer us. Lesson number three is to obey God. When you have gone to Him and He has instructed you, you obey Him. I will run through the lessons again. Number one is you should trust God. Trust Him because He is able to do all things. Lesson number two, learn to go to Him in prayers. Lesson number three is when you go to Him in prayers, when you go to Him to ask Him for anything because you trust Him, He will instruct you, He will answer your prayers. You should follow His instructions, just like Moses and Aaron did. They followed and they went to strike the rock. Some children would have been complaining, how can water come out from the rock? That's not true. That's not possible. That takes us to our memory verse for today. Memory verse. Matthew 19:26. And it says, but Jesus looked at them and said, for mortals it is impossible, but for God all things are possible. Again, Matthew 19:26. But Jesus looked at them and said, for mortals it is impossible, but with God all things are possible. I have a song for you. Our Lord God, Thou art made the heavens and the earth with Your great power. Our Lord God, Thou art made the heavens and the earth with Thy outstretched hand. Nothing is too difficult for Him. Nothing is too difficult for Him. Because great and mighty God, great in counsel, mighty indeed. Nothing, absolutely nothing, nothing is too difficult for Him. Remember your lessons. One is to trust in God because He can do all things. Two is to go to God in prayers. Three is when God answers you and instructs you and He speaks to you, you obey Him. Our topic again is water from the rock. Let's bow down our heads for prayers. Our dear Lord, we thank You for today. We give You all the glory. We thank You for teaching us that You can do all things and everything is possible for You. May Your name alone be glorified in our lives. In Jesus' almighty name we have prayed. Amen. I love you all. Bye-bye.